So, for this one here, we wanted to make sort of like a dessert slash energy bar. You know, maybe you might be a little more active in the summer, going on walks or hikes. It's always good to have a snack with you as well. And so we're going to create a really nice snack inspired by the Brazil nuts. And in my head, Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, which is my heart's pleasure.
Yeah, so Brazil nuts actually are, like I was saying earlier, the antioxidant selenium has some, the research is showing that including like high amounts of selenium in the blood may have a protective mechanism for bladder cancer. And so enjoying any type of food that's high in selenium in different amounts is really great. And so nuts tend to be one of those foods that have selenium and are absorbed well in the body. And actually, the nut that has the highest amount of selenium is Brazil nut. So it's not usually a nut that we have all that often, but we figured we would make this type of snack, dessert, with a nut that maybe you wouldn't always buy and you could hopefully taste and be inspired to get. And so it's always great to get your antioxidants through food as opposed to supplements. So this is, you know, yet another way. And we do have sunflower seeds here too because they do contain selenium as well. Not as much as the Brazil nuts, but again, having a variety is always great. And you are including fiber and protein from the seeds and nuts as well, which have protective mechanisms for heart health. No, we do not advise to have the supplement. Always have through food is the best.
Okay. So these are large flaked oats. We have the sunflower seeds that Stephanie mentioned, and we have our Brazil nuts.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are going to go in. I know I'm going to make spill everywhere.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna, and you can always go to a store like Salt Barn, which carries, you know, all sorts of nuts, and instead of buying a pack that you're kind of dedicating yourself to eating all of them, and you're not really sure how you want to eat them or use them, for sure go the bulk barn and just get the amount that you need or want to try it out.
So these are going to go in dry. What I did ahead of time was with dates, I just soaked them with some warm water. Okay, so you can cover them. They need to soak for about 5 minutes. Just so they're soft enough so that when we add it to the mixture, it breaks through. And especially if you have really stale dates, give them a little bit more time. So bring them back to life, soften them up a little bit. But for this, we have our oats, sunflower seeds, nuts, and we're going to turn this on, plugged in, and then you want to fire it up.
Yeah.
Is it down or up? I don't know.
Oh, up.
Up, down, on, up.
So we have a great bit of sound. And for a little bit more, see the larger. Yeah, and what we're doing is, as we're breaking this down with the Brazil nuts, the oils are coming out, and it's going to soften it up. This is a great way to make, like, a nut butter. If you kept going, it would turn into really soft, almost a peanut butter or almond butter.
Wow.
Okay, let's go. Brazil butter. Because of these oils, it will be the best nut butter that's going to last you a long time as well. But for us, what we need is equipment.
That's great.
Fantastic. And so you can see it's starting to actually clump up a little bit. And there are a few little chunks of okay, but it's starting to get a little softer. And at this point, we can add our dates. And the dates are actually going to be the main source of sweetener for this as well. So we're not actually adding anything else to sweeten it up.
So who has a sweet tooth? Yeah. So obviously,
it certainly says everybody.
I do as well. So, you know, it's always great to enjoy and indulge in treats once in a not while for special occasions. But I always advise that, you know, try to get your sweets or that sugary taste from natural sources. So a baked good always great to make dishes that include dates as a sweetener, or that bananas, applesauce, if you're experiencing digestive like constipation, adding some prunes in is also a great way to sweeten up a dish. But you want to aim to limit those packaged foods that have high sugar content, from candies or sugar sweetened beverages, because those are adding calories that are not nutrient dense. There's nothing, you know, there's no more nutrient density to them.
So far enough. At the top, you want to see that you're going to make some food. If it's not breaking down, work on some of the soaking liquid from the dates. You're going to add a little bit at a time. So as it's pulsing, pulse and then I can add a little bit.
There
it looks pretty good. What do you think? Really nice, and you can go a little bit further to make it even smoother. But once this, and it's a little warm because of the soaking of the dates, once it's cool, it's gonna be pretty nice and solid. So that's the mixture, ready to go. We want to put it into a pan. We're using our friend parchment paper again. A little trick to get it into a pan is it's pretty easy to put it on a flat pan, but if you want to fit it into this pan, just run it under some water. And crunch it up in your pan, and you can squeeze any excess water. And then, you can unravel it again, and it's a lot more malleable. You can actually fit it into the pan this way. I know you look like you're doing this, but I'm pretty sure you don't want to be doing this after. So, and then that goes into here, so you want to scoop out as much as possible. You can do these in like little muffin tins or cups, anything that you want to sort of set it in. And you want to go about an inch or so high. So that's going to go in there. And then you can top it. I have some dark chocolate milk on the side.
So I have another question. Who's a chocolate lover? Survey says everyone. Yeah, so dark chocolate, like red grape, black tea, green tea, blueberries, they have something known as flavonoids, which are an antioxidant. And more research is hinting that these types of flavonoids play a role in heart's health, right? And they may reduce blood pressure and the bad cholesterol, so that LDL. But what's important to remember is that these benefits of the flavonoids actually only occur most potently with dark chocolate, right? So when you're looking or buying dark chocolate, you want to just make sure somewhere on the label it says that the cocoa content, the percent cocoa content is 70% or more.
Perfect. So for you did a great job. And as flat as possible, you can even use a little bit of plastic wrap or even a little bit of parchment to make it even flatter. But I'm covering it up with chocolate, so you won't see that. So we have our melted chocolate. I use a double boiler, so that's pretty much using a bowl over a small pot of simmering water, and then the heat from the water will heat up the bowl, and that'll melt the chocolate. You can do it in the microwave as well. Just do it in small intervals, like 30 seconds, maybe two or three times until it's melted.
Like, stir it, right?
Yeah, exactly. And then I'm going to pour it over top. Now, this is going to give you lots of squares and snacks. It's not one serving, so.
Right, because too many calories can lead to obesity and diabetes, disease, and other types of cancers. So you just want to make sure that you're definitely, you know, watching your calorie content. But again, enjoying treats from that are sweet from natural sources is always the best way to go. And, you know, you could always freeze it and have it for, you know, keep it in your freezer, have a little bite for later on.
Yeah, this will go right in the fridge to set. And then I have my magic.
Oh.
Some of you No bacon. And that's it set. I even put some more sunflower seeds on top. And then the beautiful thing, again, while putting it in the parchment, is this comes out really easy. And you can see, it's all set there, good to go. And so you can cut it up into your little squares. And I think putting it in the freezer, like Stephanie mentioned, is the best way to actually store it. So cut it up, and then throw it into a Ziploc, into the freezer, and then it keeps a lot longer. And it's really tasty to get out of the freezer.
That's the last question.
And the last recipe, and I want to thank for Devin's and Bladder Cancer Canada again for joining us today.
For more information, www.bladdercancercanada.org.